Hey, what's up, y'all? Y'all know my slogan. I don't know it all, but I know what I've been through. Now, before we get into this video, please make sure you head on down to Instagram and follow us on our official Instagram page at @hookahanonymous_. All right, we're able to be a little more explicit, a little more uncensored, and share content freely without running the risk of having our channel terminated. So once again, make sure you head on down to Instagram and follow us on our official Instagram page at @hookahanonymous_. All right, now let's get into what you guys came here to see. Now, it's looking like we finally found out the reason why the Migos kind of like low-key discreetly broke up. All right, a lot of us from the outside looking in didn't really know what was going on. All we seen was it Takeoff? Takeoff and Quavo seemed like they doing their own thing. They came out with their own little, you know, project called Nephew and Unk or Unk and Few, whatever the case may be. And it seems like since then, Offset been doing his own thing. He's been running around with Cardi. You see him with Cardi B all the time, his wife. You see him with the kid. You see him like by himself. You know, he's going to fashion shows. And it's like, yo, so what happened? And a lot of people were thinking maybe they fell out. You know, and maybe it was amongst the members. But y'all got to remember, it was kind of weird to me when everybody was saying that they fell out together, because if I'm not mistaken, Quavo, Offset, and Takeoff, they're all real family members. You know, so I don't think it's anything that these guys could go through that'll break them up, because they're already family members. So it's like, you know, I'm going to see you at the family reunion anyway. I'm going to see you when you go to grandma house. I'm going to see you when you go to auntie house. So at the end of the day, it's like we can't always be mad at each other. And it's never going to get to the extent where we're going to do some type of harm or foul play or whatever to each other, right? So at the end of the day, we was all kind of stuck as to why these guys coincidentally broke up. But now it's starting to make sense. Offset is having problems with CEOP. All right, that's the guy when it comes to quality control music. Him and Coach, they're the two brains when it comes to the whole QC label, right? So now it will make sense to why your boy Offset is distanced from the group, because he's not getting along with the boss. And whenever that's the case, it never ends right, especially for the artist, because at the end of the day, you know, the boss has more leverage, whether it's your publishing, your masters, whatever it is. They got more leverage over you because they are rightfully the boss. So it all makes sense as to why today it seems like some things are coming out where Offset may have a lawsuit against QC, quality control boss, CEOP. And it spewed over into Twitter. So we're going to get into all that. Make sure y'all jump in the comments. Let me know how y'all feel, because this is the thing. I'm surprised it even got out, because, you know, QC was kind of like inseparable. You know, they had a whole bunch of artists, and we never really see the artists beef with each other. But I'm going to tell you one thing. I knew it was going to get sour, because as much as they tried to hide, you know, and blanket the beef between Lil Baby and Offset, and that little, you know, the 4PF, and it's not really 4PF and Quavo in them, you know, as a whole. It's really Offset and whatever Offset had with the 4PF guys and whatever. You know, the whole allegations of him getting stripped and robbed by the 4PF guys. And, you know, it's been swept under the rug, I'm guessing, because they all under the same umbrella. But however, we always knew that little tension was there, because they throw little subliminals against each other all over social media. So you already know what's going. Now, your boy Offset took to his Twitter account today, right? And he said this. He said, quote, "This new chapter for me is personal." And he put the exclamation marks. Now, QCMP, you know, CEOP, he took to his Twitter account as well. I guess he's seen it and he had to respond. He said, quote, "The last lawsuit was filed publicly and dismissed quietly. Let's see how this one go. Been too real for all this lame-ish. Everyone know the real problem." Now, I wonder what he mean by "know the real problem." Could he be talking about maybe Cardi B is a distraction to Offset? Maybe Offset been, you know, not focused and more doing, you know, his Cardi B and family thing? Who knows? Or maybe he's just talking about Offset as an overall. He's the problem when it comes to the group. And as I described earlier, maybe he's the what's that? The bad seed between Lil Baby and the whole Migos thing. Cause just be real, if Migos and Lil Baby had a song together, I think that'll be fire. But somehow, some way, these guys been on the same label forever and haven't done nothing. And whenever you ask each side about, you know, one or the other, they always give you like some awkward response. It's kind of weird. But anyway, Offset took to his Twitter account to repost what P said, and he said, quote, N-words act like I'm the problem. I paid millions to get my rights back. N-word, you blackball me. I ain't said ish one time, homie. I ain't spoke to you in 2 years. Now I drop and you want your name on my credit. So this is seeming like a situation, because as y'all know, Offset just put out a record with Moneybagg Yo. It sounded alright. And he's going pretty much on his solo career. So he's saying that, you know, he paid millions to get his rights back. I don't know, when he say rights, maybe he means masters and publishing and everything. You know, it's sticky when you do that, because nobody wants to, you know, take their part. Nobody, no boss wants to give their publishing back, because that's how they get their money from the artist. You know, whether you solo or not, if I own your masters and your publishing and all that, it's not but so much you could do without me getting paid. I'm gonna get paid regardless. You know, so I'm pretty sure maybe that's what he's referring to. But at the end of the day, he said that he was being blackballed and he haven't spoken to P in 2 years. So like I said, that could be where the problem stems from. You know, this whole time, for 2 years, we didn't know. It's only as of recent when the Migos broke up and everybody was wondering why. But now we're understanding that it's been a real problem for about 2 years. And maybe that's why you started seeing Offset more with Cardi B. You know, start seeing him more around his family, away from the guys, away from the QC, away from the parties, the events. You know, he was away from all that. He just been with Cardi and his family. So is that a bad thing? No. But at the end of the day, business, I guess, is business, never personal. Let's see how this one goes. He says he's been blackballed. I've been hearing Offset, so I don't know how blackballed he's been. So let's see what comes out of this, man. I never thought this day would come, to be honest with you. So jump in the comments, let me know how y'all feel. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit that bell so you're notified every time we drop new content. And remember, as long as you keep on watching, I'm gonna keep on dropping, and I'm out.